Hello friends, I am going to start one topic about aspect to be considered while drawing a diagram. See, the question comes when you are drawing a diagram or a graph. It does not mean diagram, but also considered to be graph. Which aspects you have to keep in your mind when you are preparing a graph or a diagram? So the answer is divided in 6 points. See, you all know that when you are preparing a graph, you need to think about its measure on x, what you want to show. On y, x, what you want to show. These all things you have to keep in your mind, and you are already thinking about it. So it is not a new thing to remember. So first point is choice of diagram or a graph. This is your first point. As I said, the first point means it is a title, right? See, as by the detail, you decide what you want to prepare. Because in exam, nobody will say, it is not necessary that they will say you bar diagram or linear sketch or pie diagram you have to show. But indicate, instead of that, they can say you show following details on appropriate diagram or graph. So here it is not necessary that they will make it clear, but they will leave it to you. So you have already understood earlier that for which kind of the data you have to show the graph, and for which kind of the data you have to show pie diagram. So it is up to the student, it will remain. So here the first point, choice of the type of diagram or graph. Usually diagram is useful for making explanation and presentation effective regarding the given data. So as according to the requirement, the presenter has to make the right choice about graph or diagram effectively according to data, right? Second point is clarity. Here you have to remember, just to prepare the graph in a small one or a bigger one is not important. But show the picture, graph or diagram neat and clear. Confusing picture cannot create the impressive effect. So the diagram or the graph must needed to be clear and neat. As according to requirement, specific shades, specific image, a presenter could use it. Regarding to components of picture, to notify specific signs, image, he can use it. It is also included here. Third point, appropriate scale and measure. See, sometimes the data will be given 1%, 2%, 3%, up to 90%. So at that time, 1 centimeter is equal to 1%. So how much large graph you will need? It is not possible. So here you keep in your mind, appropriate size and scale must be taken in accordance to the data. And usually when you are preparing the graph, the scale usually taken 1 centimeter is equal to 5%. Right? This is the general situation which I am stating here. The fourth point is representation of axis. See, generally on the graph, you know that two axes are there, x and y. X will always showing unchanged values or the information, as like the time, as like the country, right? So it will be used for unchanged value, and Y will be used for changing value. So here, according to the requirement, the student can prepare his graph or diagram as per the data in proper axis. The fifth one is data table and source of data. You all know that from where the data is being taken is more important. If your data is unauthentic, then your evaluation analysis will also be in anyhow, nobody will give it importance. So the data must be taken from authentic source, which make the graph more authentic and reliable. The next and last point of the answer is method of calculating data. Means on which method you are calculating the data to show it. See, generally you all knows that diagram is a self-explanatory and graph is required in statistical form to show the measure. So appropriate method briefly indicate where it is required to show how the data has been calculated and presented, right? This is your answer, which has been completed in the 6 points. Okay.